Hello there, Jeffrey.
Hi.
This is show number 628. We're in the studio. We have brand new microphones. We have an engineer. We have new gear. So hopefully this sounds better.
How do we sound?
I don't know. Hopefully we sound good.
I have headsets, so everybody sounds weird.
You know, these are the same microphones I used to use when I was in radio. These are the
Are they Shure's?
EVRE20s.
Is that a Shure
25s. Or, no. It's Electro Voice.
Oh.
These are some high-end microphones.
Do I sound electric?
You sound pretty good. So anyway, but welcome to the show. You and I have been traveling. We've been away. We've done a show. I went to West Virginia. You went to
England.
The West Virginia version of wherever you were in England, the UK
Actually,
version.
Actually, you know what? We both went to like interesting, way out of the way,
rural,
posh estates.
Okay.
For games reasons. It was very unusual.
Yeah, it was great. So it's as we record this, it's October 5th. So let's see. We got Assassin's Creed out.
Oh, there's so many.
This
week we have
Forza Horizon 4. Do you want to go through that? Do you want to talk about what we're playing?
Why don't we do that? You know, for tradition's sake, right?
Yeah.
What we're playing?
Boy, one of my Forza Horizon 4.
That's a good one.
Which released this week for everybody. You and I have been playing a little bit of that. We did some of the multiplayer before it released.
We did. We need to do more of that.
We need to do that Halo level.
Oh, that's a really good one. Have you played it yet?
Yes, I have.
Yeah, that's a lot of fun. I wonder if we can co-op that.
I think you can. I'm pretty sure you can, because I co-opted one of the other showcase events with somebody.
Yeah, Forza Horizon 3, you could have the Warthog.
Yeah.
I forgot exactly how you unlocked it. Once you had it, by the way, it was super OP. It was like all the off-road races, I was using the Warthog.
Right.
But this one, it's just everything from the music to the voiceover to the whole conceit of this level is all Halo, and it's really phenomenal.
It's like the way I described it. I was talking to somebody from, I think I was talking to Phil. I'm like, it's like a perfect espresso. It's concentrated. It's quick. It's a quick hit, and you're done.
Yeah.
Right. And it's everything about it is just perfect. So it was a lot of fun.
You do love your espresso.
I do. I do. I need to get my little caffeine. I have my two today. Do you have any today?
No, and you can tell.
I had two this morning. I feel good. I feel good. Yeah. Anyway.
You're vibrating. So what else besides Forza?
Let's see. What else am I playing? You know, I keep going back to the Far Cry 5 expansion, the one on Mars with Herc.
Oh, I haven't done
that one. We should do that. It's a lot of fun. So I just did that for a little bit of single player action. Of course, I finished Tomb Raider. I don't know if
that was good. I finished it as well.
Yeah, you finished that. That was a lot of fun.
What'd you think?
I loved it. I mean, what's not to love? It's a great single player experience, and it was a fun experience. And there's a lot, some DLC coming along.
I think that game had my favorite moment in gaming this year,
which is
I'll do it as non-spoilery as possible.
Do it as best you can.
So the thing that this game had that I think the last two Tomb Raiders didn't were like these really cool set piece sequences, like sort of escape sequences. I think there were probably four of them. Throughout the game, four or five. And after one of them, Lara sort of falls into some water. And when she comes out, she's sort of like galvanized and like ready to take no prisoners.
Yeah.
She undergoes some manner of like transformation. And when she comes out of the water,
Apocalypse Now-esque.
Yes. Yeah, and she was like silhouetted.
And
at that point, the enemies are scared of her.
Right.
That moment was just, I was like, yes.
Yeah.
And I just, the game is supposed to be, this was like something of a trilogy of Lara becoming Lara.
Mm-hmm.
Like if you go back to Tomb Raider 2013.
Right.
She was just a student, you know, and who goes on to go through a lot of trials. And now these three games have gone and she is the Tomb Raider now.
Yes, she is.
I loved it.
Loved it too. Yeah. Give it a shot.
Yeah. Have you been playing it? All the sports games are out now.
Oh, FIFA's
NHL,
out,
FIFA,
NHL.
Have you? I know normally you play a few Madden games.
We have not played our yearly Madden game, and I'm really disappointed.
We can do that. I'm going to make time for you this weekend.
Thank you. Thank you. I'll make time for you. I was thinking about NHL. Is Fuzzy in the game or Zippy or
so
Mangy? What's his name?
What you're talking about is you're talking about the new Philadelphia Flyers mascot.
Which is, by the way, getting a lot of airtime.
He's getting a ton. His name is Gritty.
Gritty. Okay, that's what it was.
And
Zippy.
It's supposed to
smelly,
be like the...
Gritty the Clown.
If you haven't seen Gritty, I'll link to him in the show notes.
Oh, warning. Adult discretion is advised. He's disturbing.
Yeah, I mean, he looks not that different than someone who was in like Animals Band from the Muppets.
Right.
Where the electric...
Right.
Mayhem.
I think you're right.
Yeah. But like he had
on skates.
On skates, and he had two espressos like you did
right,
this morning.
Because
his eyes are just completely like buzzed open. And the thing is, I've noticed, like, at first I was like, you can't just manufacture something like this. Like, I'm from Philly, obviously, right. The Philly fanatic who is like a complete, like, what the heck are you?
Right.
But yet it's worked. I'm like, you can't just do that again.
Guess what?
It seems to be working.
They did.
People are really into, I just continually see Gritty, like, popping up in memes. His first game, he fell on the ice and was like, yeah, ice is slippery, Gritty.
Yeah.
I don't know why, but I'm a big fan of Gritty. And he's you know what? You lightning can strike twice.
So if you need to check this. Now, it's interesting. Other than Japan, I'm trying to remember. Like, in Europe, with all of the football games, i.e. soccer, they don't really have mascots.
Oh, no, you're...
Am I wrong?
That's where you're wrong.
Okay. You're the European soccer expert outside of Graham.
So Arsenal, my football team from North London, got to go to a match a couple weeks ago.
You did.
They have Gunnersaurus.
Oh.
Which is just as nonsensical as Gritty and the Philly fanatic.
Right.
I know Chelsea has a couple of like sort of panthers. So they definitely are mascots.
I misspoke then. Thank you.
Well, I'd like to think this was a learning moment.
It is. You know? It is a teaching moment.
Now, I'd have to imagine that was like a nod to Americanism. I don't know how far back Gunnersaurus goes in the pantheon. I don't imagine in the 1930s, Gunnersaurus was prowling up and down the
But we don't know.
We don't know.
We weren't there.
I wasn't there. No.
All right, so what else are we playing? I want to say it's because we've been traveling so much. You've been traveling. We did a live show. Yeah. It feels like it was a week and a half ago we did the live show.
It feels longer.
It does feel longer. Inside Xbox, you and Graham went out to this Goodwood Estate, which is this lovely estate in the middle of South England.
Yes.
UK. And Ricari and I stayed here in Redmond, and we went back and forth, and it was a lot. Tell us about your trip out there. Where was it, and what was going on?
Yeah, so if you're not super into racing, if you are, you're going to be very familiar with the Goodwood Festival of Speed. But if not... So there's a Duke who's very high up in the English monarchy, the Duke of Richmond. Mm-hmm. So this guy's like one level down from like Prince Harry and like the people you've heard of. And he has a 12,000 acre estate in South England in between Portsmouth and Brighton, if that helps place you on the map.
Thank you.
I don't know if it did. And it's beautiful, as most Duke's estates would be in your mind. In fact, it looks exactly like you would imagine.
Yep.
And this guy's super into racing. And he literally did, if you watch the show, he did let us borrow his son's Jaguar.
Was that his son's?
That literally was his son's. And we never told his son that we were going to put Xbox Live or Xbox Game Pass codes all over it.
Right.
But the Duke said it was cool, so... We did it.
And he's the Duke.
He's the Duke.
It's his property.
And it was like this beautiful like 1960s era.
That was a funny moment because I remember I was standing in the control room and the satellite feed of you standing in front of that Jaguar was coming back. And I was like, oh my gosh, look at that. Because it was a great image. You were in front of it. You know, Graham was taking a selfie. But you could clearly see the codes all over this thing. And I was like, that's not just like some random car. That's a classic Jaguar.
Yes. And 5,000 codes. It had never been more valuable than at that moment.
That's true.
Yeah. So we went out there. So he does this big festival speed. There's a racetrack out there. There is horse racing. Apparently cricket. The rules of cricket were... laid down there, like someone was pointing that out, and if I liked cricket, I would have been very moved.
Cricket confuses me.
I'm
fascinated by it, but it confuses me.
I just know that a cricket bat is what you want in hand during the zombie apocalypse. If you've ever seen Shaun of the Dead, as always. So it was kind of amazing. So what we did is we essentially took over the Duke's house. The Duke was home, and we took over his whole first floor. We brought in media and content creators from around the world.
Yep,
and we basically made the Horizon Festival come to life.
Mm-hmm.
So when you
tents,
it was like literally exactly like the Horizon Festival. There were cars everywhere. There was racing. People were staying out there in tents. There was music. They had games playing, up until late in the night. It was pretty remarkable, and it was great. We were able to like put some of these creators into rally cars with people like Tanner Faust. People got to
How
ride.
Is he?
He's awesome. He's
great. You've seen me wear his. Do you remember when I had?
I remember when you put in his racing suit. It was quite
embarrassing.
That was when the rating moved from T for teen straight up into M.
He's a little bit smaller than I am, so I'll let you guys figure that one out.
He was great, and he was taking folks out on rides. Like the Hunicorn was there. So Ken Block, I didn't know a lot about the Hunicorn What I know now, yeah. besides the fact that it's like 900 horsepower, it is the loudest car in existence.
Louder than those one, the that car in PUBG.
Louder.
That one's loud. Yeah.
Louder than like an Airbus A380.
Right.
Like we were inside, you could hear that thing popping and screech. Like it is so bursting with power that it just cannot be contained.
Like me right now in my espresso.
You're making me, I'm having some real caffeine sort of jealousy here. But it was just amazing to see him going out there and doing donuts. Like at one point, I like just sort of ran him like, oh my God, you're Ken Block.
You had a bunch of folks there. You had cars. Yep. You had some folk. You had the Mountain from Game of Thrones.
The Mountain, who's really big. His name is Hafþór Bjornsson. He's not even full Thor.
He's not even full Thor. He's half Thor.
And he's 6'8".
Is he as big as you? I mean, I know that in TV, they'll like cheat some angles to make him look bigger, but he looks enormous.
I don't know if I'm supposed to be saying this. We had to make a special menu for him while he was there. He like put his request in. The man essentially eats like 6 meals a day. And
so what was he eating?
He was eating, actually it was like very like high protein, low carb, but like multiple chickens per day.
Oh my.
Like more eggs than you could possibly harvest in a day. You know, protein shakes and I mean, it was like it gallons and gallons of like chicken broth.
Oh.
Yeah.
So in a shake?
I don't think it necessarily was in a shake, although I mean, you know, we could try that out. Ugh,
no thanks.
No. You didn't have you don't like a chicken shake?
No.
I'm sure it's popular up there in Iceland where he's from.
Or yeah. somewhere.
So but he was very nice. Julia Hardy, our good friend
Julia Hardy.
He lifted her up. Basically, he just sort of lifted his arm up and she was able to hang off of him like he was a structure built into the ground because essentially he is.
Yeah.
Wherever he goes, he's just a movable building.
A lot of stuff going on out there. While you were there, we were back here in Redmond. We talked about a couple things. Talked about the next system update coming to Xbox, which should be coming in a few weeks, I believe. Mm-hmm. Which has avatars, it has Cortana, it has Alexa integration. Hey, Alexa, start up my Xbox.
That's pretty cool.
Hey, Alexa, start a party with Jeff Rubenstein.
You should do that. Or just Rubes.
So we had that show. Who else do we have? We had a bunch of stuff on that show. It was a lot of fun. We had Nick from Fortnite come up from Epic Games. Yeah. I got some Fortnite on the show. We talked about that, which that release came out.
Got to kick off season 6. You know what? I've gotten into it.
Really?
Yeah. Like I played a little bit of Fortnite here and there, but my daughter really, she took a break from Overwatch. I think because of peer pressure, you know, it's a thing.
It's everybody's
all
playing
the kids,
it.
It's all the kids are playing it. Yeah. So she was like, you know what? I'm going to sit down. And you know what?
How's she
I'll
doing?
Be darned if she's not better than I am. In solo, she's finished second a few times. Wow. She's a 9-year-old, you know?
Right.
And these are the kids that beat you.
Right.
9-year-old. So
look no further than your couch.
So I went in, we both bought the season 6 battle pass. And you know what? We're having a lot of fun. You know, as a parent, you try to find things to bond with your kids.
Sure.
And
I'm sure I'll be doing that with my daughter.
Exactly. You should get her in there. You should buy her the battle pass now so she gets these collector skins. And, you know, 5 or 6 years from now when she's ready to, maybe 7 or 8 years from now when she's ready to play, she'll have what will be vintage skins.
Or whatever the next
whatever
the
Fortnite. Next thing is.
Yeah, there's always something.
Yeah. But it was really cool having, and you just made that happen. You were like, you know what? I want Fortnite on the show.
Well, it was just one of those things where I was like, I've known Nick and the guys at Epic and Fortnite. I'm like, hey, you guys got some stuff. They said, yeah, we'd love to. They flew all the way out here for it. They flew all the way up here from North Carolina right after a hurricane.
Well, I mean, you don't want to stick around, right?
I guess not. So you did that. I, on the other hand, went to West Virginia.
You know, I've had some experiences in West Virginia, and so I'm very eager to hear yours.
So West Virginia, the reason we went to West Virginia is Bethesda was doing an event, and you'll see some of the news coming out. I believe next week is when the embargo lifts.
It's for Fallout 76.
Correct, Fallout 76. So I'll have some details on that. But it was great. Went out to West Virginia to this place called the Greenbrier Resort, which is called America's Resort.
Really? It belongs to all of us.
So it has been here since like the late 1700s.
Well, I mean,
it is extraordinary. This place is massive. Of course, Fallout 76 takes place in West Virginia, so this location is actually in the game.
Did they have John Denver on just loop the whole as soon as you walked in?
Well, they've got that special version they've done.
Yeah, they almost have. I guess it's not John Denver.
It's the reason why Greenbrier is because of. I think, let me just look it up. I want to make sure I refer to it properly. But the reason we're out there in, what is it? Hold on a second.
I'm going to link to this. It is America's resort since 1778.
I told you.
Yeah. We didn't even have a constitution back then.
This predates. Anyway, so the reason we went there is because there's this interesting thing called Project Greek Island.
Mm. Tell me more about this Assassin's Creed related thing.
Well, this is interesting. That was the name of the, it was a super top secret project that was started in the late 50s. Basically, it was to provide in case there was a nuclear event.
It's pronounced nuclear, honey.
In case there's a nuclear event, that this was going to provide the continuation.
Larry, it's nuclear. You're not Homer Simpson. Nuclear.
Nuclear. So in case there's an event, that basically it was to continue the American government, the seat of government, the Senate, the Congress, the branches of...
And so the way, they just go down underground and wait
no,
for...
No, no, no. So let me explain this to you. Me. So Project Greek Island is what happened. It was there was secretly at the Greenbrier, in the late 50s, the early 60s, they were putting on an expansion. They needed a new wing, Jeff. More people were coming there.
I can totally identify.
Well, it turns out they did need a new wing, but that was a cover story.
Oh, this is where conspiracy theories come in.
So
it's true.
The cover story is that they were building this. And they were building the wing, but under the wing was a real-life fallout bunker, which where the U.S. government would go in case of an attack. So sure enough, this entire thing was built over, I think it was 2 or 3 years, and it is a massive underground facility that is exactly what you think. There's a 30, 40, 50-ton door that crashes at the entrance to this 400-foot tunnel. I mean, it's everything you would think from a Fallout game, but it is in real life. So this was secret.
Did you run into the tunnel snakes?
I'm going to tell you this. This was secret from 1962, and it went right up till 1992 until the Washington Post wrote a story on it and basically outed the whole thing, and then they decommissioned it. So this is, we did a tour of this, and this area, this bunker is in Fallout 76. I don't know what role it has, but it is in the game.
That's pretty cool. So let's say you're stuck in this bunker. You know, bad things happen. You're a congressman from the great state of Connecticut.
Sure.
Sure. And you're ushered into the Greenbrier Resort.
So this is what happens. Want me to explain to you what would happen?
Greenbrier last resort at that point.
So this is back in the 50s and early 60s and early 70s, nuclear warheads were delivered via airplane. So we had a sense we had a few hours before the airplane would show up and drop the bomb.
Yeah, you can
leisurely
make out your will.
Right.
You can finish beating a game.
Right.
Or something, you
can make sure you're packing properly.
Last meal.
And they would put all the congressmen and women and whatnot, the folks from Congress and the government onto a plane in Washington, and they would fly the three or four hours out to this airstrip, which was right near the resort. They would take them out and bring them into the bunker. Well, what happened was late 70s, 80s, and 90s, early 90s, that nuclear warheads were now put on top of missiles. So instead of having a few hours, you had a few minutes. So that's one of the reasons it didn't make any more sense.
This is taking a very dark turn, Larry.
In any event, so you go down this 400, you get past the security clearance, you go down this 400-foot tunnel. And these bunkers, if you go to Greenbrier, you can take a bunker tour. And I highly recommend it. You go down this 400-foot tunnel, and you are scanned, Jeffrey.
For?
Radioactivity. If you are radioactive, then you go through this tiny little door. You take all of your clothes off, and you push them into this little hole, which goes down to an incinerator.
They've thought of everything.
You then work your way down this narrow passageway with all the showers, with all the water. And there's like at the head, at the midsection of the, and you're being showered to clear yourself of this radioactivity.
And they're playing Radioactive by Imagine Dragons.
And you come out the other side and you are, I swear this is true, Jeff. You are given a jumpsuit.
With a number, 76 on the
back? Don't know, but you come out and then from there, you get into the facility and there's a dormitory, there's bathrooms, there's a kitchen. I sent you a picture of the kitchen. There's a theater where that's where the seats of Congress would meet to decide what to do next. So it is a fascinating, fascinating facility. And you should link to the Project Greek Island page on Wikipedia.
Yeah, I'll go ahead and I'll do that, as well as the Greenbrier itself, which you apparently can visit because it's America's resort.
Yeah.
Much in the way the Braves are America's team.
So this was, anyway, we were down there, we played it, we saw it, and this is in the middle of nowhere. This resort is, you talked about the Duke's estate. How big was it?
12,000 acres.
So this is 11,000 acres. For those of you that have trouble with it, and I know that I'm gonna equate it roughly to the size of one of the most popular attractions in America.
Disney?
Yes. That is, I believe, 25,000 acres.
Just Disneyland or World?
Disney World in Florida.
Okay.
And located in the, you as the congressperson from the great state of Florida.
Orange County.
It is, so it's about half the size of Disney World. And anybody, and I know millions of people have been there, know how big that is.
Mm-hmm.
So this is, I was on a resort that was half the size, and you're saying the Duke owned property that was about,
Anyway,
so this is an amazing, amazing facility. Of course, the Greenbrier does a golf tournament each year, which is world renowned. So anyway, Greenbrier, fascinating. You'll come across it in Fallout 76. Fallout 76 comes out next month, and we'll have details about what we did down there probably in next week's this week on Xbox.
Well, I can't wait to play it.
Yeah, we do. It's the multiplayer was a lot of fun, and you'll hear. I got a chance to spend some time with Pete Hines, who's a great good friend of Xbox and so forth. So
very cool.
Anyway, so that was my Greenbrier, and it took a lot to get there.
Yeah, that's a real planes, trains, and automobiles sort of there.
We landed in the Greenbrier at the county airport, and I'm pretty sure after we got off the plane onto the tarmac, I'm pretty sure what do they call them? The person
stair car? You're talking like the controller, the person holding the
yeah, the what do they call
we
called?
Say air, it's not the air traffic controller because we're in the tower.
No.
But the person
the ground
holding
crew.
Ground crew, sure.
Yeah, so the ground crew, he opens up and there's like three or four of them. I'm pretty sure he went over and like hit a switch to shut off the runway lights. Because we were the only flight that evening.
Right.
It was kinda crazy.
Did he unload the baggage?
Oh yeah.
He did it all.
Oh yeah. It was fascinating. So anyway, beautiful. I mean, West Virginia was lovely. It was really a beautiful part of the country, beautiful time of the year. It was really warm. I was quite surprised. So hello to all the Xbox fans. It's funny. I'm in Chicago. I didn't tell you this. I'm in Chicago and this plane pulls in that we're going to get on. Of course, they deplane it and the crew gets off and the crew's the last to get off. And I pass the pilot of the incoming flight off. He stops and turns and recognizes me.
Really?
Yeah. He and I were going back and forth on Instagram. But it was really, he was like, what are you doing? I told him he was really excited. Then I got to Greenbrier and one of the doormen recognized me, and he's a gamer. He's really excited that the place he works is going to be in a video game.
Everyone's a gamer.
Yeah. You and I have come across this around the world. And it is lovely when we get to connect with people about what we do and this great industry of ours.
Yeah, we are truly lucky.
So that was my trip there. We'll have more details on that next week on This Week on Xbox.
I can't wait to look at it.
Yeah. Yeah. What else do we have?
What else? A couple other games came out recently that I just wanted to talk about very briefly. One is Valkyria Chronicles 4. It's a game I don't think you're going to play, Larry. But this is a game
You judge me so quickly.
I do.
You
because I know you. How long have I known you, Larry? More than
a decade.
This is not a game you're going to be playing.
Okay.
Watch, now you're going to play it. But it is, I would say if you're interested in alternate universe World War II, beautiful,
is this where alternate universe
graphics,
is this
anime?
A fancy way of saying that the Nazis won?
No. It takes
interesting.
So it takes place literally in a world that it's very reminiscent, and it takes place in what is sort of analogous to like the Netherlands or something, but it's not really. It's another, it's a town called, or country called Gallia. Anyway, it's just sort of like a major European conflict sort of reimagined.
So it's not World War II proper. It's just a major,
It's the European, it's EC2. I mean like.
EC2.
Like European conflict 2 or something like that.
Fascinating.
So it definitely takes from some of the dark stuff too that happened, you know, sort of racial divides or religious divides and things like that. Anyway, point is, it is a strategic like RPG that also has live action moments where it's like a cover-based shooter and you line up your shots and you're under fire. So I would say if you're someone who liked XCOM or someone who just sort of enjoys strategy and really likes sort of anime type games. This game is very Japanese. It's a game we never had any of the previous ones on an Xbox platform. There was a sort of an offshoot game that appeared last year, but of the mainline Valkyria games, I love this game. I've been playing. I'm only like maybe 2 or 3 hours in, but really love it. And so it's definitely worth your shot. If any of those things, any of those buzzwords I threw out at you are for you, Valkyria Chronicles 4, you won't regret it.
Wow. That's a hell of a sell.
Look, I'm trying.
I know.
Trying here. When you like something, you tell people about it. It's literally what we do.
I agree.
And then I actually jumped into, as much as I like to finish one game at a time and move on to the next, when the reviews came out this week for Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
Oh, it's downloading now. I haven't even had a chance to play
it. Oh, man. So between Forza Horizon 4 and Assassin's Creed Odyssey, already the fall's off to just a phenomenal start in terms of just quality.
And can you hear the clock ticking?
Get it out of the way. It's only
get it out of the way before Red Dead.
3 weeks from today. Yeah. That my goal is to finish Assassin's before that happens. But knowing that Origins, and I loved Origins.
You did.
I played it earlier this year, but it came out last year. Phenomenal game, and I played that for probably about 35 hours, and I screamed towards the end. And this game's even bigger. I will say that it's almost impossible for me to finish it, but it is really, really good. We have a couple articles that I actually wrote up on Xbox Wire. I had a chance to drop in and see the game.
Did you know that Jeffrey's an auteur?
You know, just what I'm one that writes. I don't think I qualify as an author. However, I happen to be in San Francisco at the same time as an Assassin's event. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna push out my plane a little bit. I'm gonna drop by just to see it. And I saw a little bit of the game, and
did you love the way listeners? You love the way he throws that out there. He's like, I'm just gonna go over to this event. You know, people would give their left arm to go to an event like that, and you're like, well, I guess I'll go.
No, it wasn't like that.
Delay
it was
my
like
flight.
I would move heaven and earth to go. I had sure. no idea I was there for Forza.
But you had the opportunity.
I had the opportunity. Look, again, never. Right. I never take that for granted.
Yeah.
And I was like, well, there's no way am I going to miss this.
Right.
So I pushed out my flight. Things were rearranged.
Sure.
You know. And so I dropped by and I already very taken with what I've seen. So I decided to spend some time talking to the art director. I'm sorry, the narrative director, Mel McCubry, and Scott Phillips, the game director, about a couple of different features that really stood out to me. And one was, you can choose your character for the first time in an Assassin's Creed.
Wow.
You can either choose Alexios, and I know you have a nice little tie-in thing there.
We'll talk about that in a minute.
And then, or you can choose Cassandra. So they're, and I was like, well, who should I choose?
Who
should you choose? And? Well, anyway, I know who I choose. I chose Cassandra. I was a femship user in the Mass Effect series, and Jennifer Hale's a fantastic voice actress. I felt like I made the right choice.
Femship. I haven't heard that in a while.
I know.
That's like an old school reference.
And I'm an old school gentleman, sir.
Yes.
And so I chose Cassandra based on the performance that I had seen her do in this event. But there is an article, and I can link to it on Xbox Wire, where I asked them both, who should I pick? And so they give a little bit of background on the sort of the voice performances for both Alexios and Cassandra. And also, they have a skill tree. That there was a skill tree in Origins, and then it's even more divided, I would say, in this one. Like, all right. You can really focus on being an assassin, being a warrior, being an archer, sort of a, you know, ranged
attacker.
Where did you go?
What did you roll?
Well, you don't roll. You can always move it.
Right.
But,
I see.
I'm spreading it out because I love
peanut butter.
I'm more of an assassin, but there's a couple really cool moves like this is Sparta kick that you can do, which should be your first move. So I asked the developers, which move should you do first?
And what's the answer?
And, that was actually their first one. But there's a number of other ones that sort of... anyway, there's an article. I'll link to it.
Please.
And it can maybe help you choose where you're going to allot those first few precious skill points. Because you're not going to finish it. You're not going to finish that whole tree in one game.
Nope.
In one playthrough. You're not going to do it. Got to make smart decisions. Anyway, so, it's really good.
Alexios, which is, they did a tie-in with Amazon Alexa, and they sent me one. I was showing it to you this morning before we came over. It's kind of great looking, isn't it?
Just imagine a Roman or a Greek warrior Alexa.
Yeah, I put it up on my Instagram. Instagram, Jeffrey.
What's this now? Instagram? Instant, is that like a telegram?
It's like a graham cracker, but it's instant.
I love
it's
graham crackers.
Simple.
Yeah, I could go for one.
Follow me on Instagram if you want to see some of the photos of that, including Instagram stories. I've been experimenting there.
Those are fun. I spend a lot of time.
You
on
do.
Those.
Yours are highly produced. Mine are more, you know, cut and run.
Well, I'm linking. I found the Alexios sort of an unboxing in three steps, and this is really cool. You can actually ask the Alexios Alexa. I guess it's a skill. Probably works for all Alexa items.
Right.
All sort of different questions about Assassin's Creed Odyssey.
Right.
You can ask them, like, where is this wolf cave? And where is... Anyway, so that's pretty cool. I'm going to link out to that.
So you'll be able to have that. And then, of course, you'll be able to use Alexa with the next update to turn your Xbox on, or Cortana. So it's going to... It's lots. The voice is the thing, Jeffrey. The voice is the thing.
Is that like a sort of a playoff of Shakespeare?
It could be.
The play's the thing.
It could be.
I feel like this is a very highfalutin episode.
I want to take it even further. On the plane, trip out to, I connected through Chicago onward to, as they say in travel, onward to West Virginia. I happened to watch a movie that I want to talk about.
Please.
I love a good documentary. And this documentary is called, it came out earlier this year, and I believe it's available on most of your digital storefronts. It's not streaming yet, you know, as part of Netflix or any of those, but you can buy it individually. You can buy it on Microsoft Movies, and I'll put a link here, or iTunes. Three Identical Strangers.
Oh, I saw this promoted on the plane.
Jeff, you have to watch this.
Okay.
It is, and I don't want to give too much away because it twists and turns and goes places that I was not expecting. But it's a true story. So it is about, I'll just give
the gist.
The high level is it's this this young guy, I think he's 21, goes off to college, and turns out he, by a sheer coincidence, went to the same college the next year, the previous year, that a twin brother that he had, that he never knew he had because they were separated at birth, went to, but that twin brother never came back. So when this guy shows up, everybody thinks it's him. Oh, you came back. So he has no idea what's going on. And somebody who was the best friend of the original first year guy says, oh, let me tell you what's going on. They drive, they meet, they're unbelievable. Isn't that unbelievable?
But there's three.
But here's where it gets crazy. And then it turns out there's a third one. So three identical, I don't want to call them twins, triplets, they were separated at birth. And they happen to be living in the greater New York area.
Huh.
And they came together. It is a fascinating story.
All right, I'm
going to
watch it. You sold me.
You know what? I didn't even do justice because the story goes so much deeper than just what I talked about.
Did you cry?
Yes. You'll see. Yeah. You'll understand why.
Okay.
Because it's you laughed, you cried. It's a roller
coaster
of emotions.
Are nothing to be afraid of.
No, I know that. I know that.
It's,
I mean,
you're allowed to admit it.
I cried at the end of Red Dead 1.
And you. Yeah. And like 30,000 people.
And a million other people listening.
Yeah.
But anyway, so go check out Three Identical Strangers. It is, Jeff, listen to me.
Yeah.
You have to watch. In fact, I need you to watch. That's your homework this weekend. I need you to
all
watch.
All right. So I'm canceling our Madden game.
I'm not saying that. Okay. Right. I'm going to cancel. You know what? You need to cancel your early morning football match.
I'm not going to do that.
Okay.
Well, I don't want to watch that movie at 7. You know, you realize watching English football means I have to set an alarm.
Right.
And I got to brew a pot of coffee and then I got to like wake up and
get
then,
up and get up.
And then
your...
they might lose.
Yeah.
And then my weekend's off to a start.
But you're sitting there in your Arsenal bathrobe and you must feel quite good.
I do. Gunnersaurus would be proud.
I wonder if he wears one. All right, what else do we have going on here? I want to talk about that. We had some surface announcements this week.
We sure did.
The team was in New York. I don't know if you have those up there. We had an update to some of the surface stuff, including, and I got to talk to Panos about this. Come on, Panos. Really?
What?
We're audio nerds. How did we not have a set of the headphones to talk about?
Look, sometimes it's nice to be surprised.
We've been so busy with
you know, Forza most recently.
Live and shows.
Exactly. And... that we haven't. So anyway... number of things announced this week: the Surface Pro 6, the Surface Laptop 2, Surface Studio 2, and the Surface headphones. So
yeah.
I have at different points used the original versions of all of these, and they look
except the headphones, because that's a new
except
product.
Except the headphones, yeah. I'm trying. I'm sure that everyone who works on that team right now is dealing with people like us going, "Where's my headphones, Kevin?" You know, I think
I'm really saying. It's not like we don't. I got a million followers on Twitter. I want to help them out. Whatever.
I know. Look, they
hey,
look
Bose,
amazing.
If you want to send me anything, we'll have it a chat about that.
Funny, I was like pantomiming to other people on the team. I'm like, he really is mad. He really wants that. The coolest feature about those headphones is that you can turn down the amount of noise canceling.
Sure.
So, I mean, when I travel, I have headphones on, and then what happens is, you know, somebody comes by or they try to get your attention, and then you got to turn them off.
Or you got to take them off.
These, when you take them off, it pauses whatever you're playing.
Right.
That's amazing.
Yeah,
no other ones
feature.
Do that. But you can just turn it down a little bit, and I can still hear you perfectly, and then turn it back up.
Yep.
It's just that little extra
thoughtful.
Thought.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Thoughtful.
That makes something incredible.
So the Surface headphones, those are coming out in a few weeks, right? They'll be available.
I don't know if we have the date on that. I'll take a look. They're not out yet, but... what I will say is that Microsoft stores, there's a number of them, over 100 around the country.
Of
they
which
tend
I've
to have
personally
these...
opened most
yes.
of them.
And your picture's up there in the back, in the break room.
It
people
is.
Can't see that.
It is.
But, you know, I want to see what these matte black surfaces look like. I love the laptop. Right now I'm using a Surface Book 2, but the laptop was what I was using before that. And that is probably the best, no, not, unequivocally the best typing experience I've ever had on a laptop. It just has such an incredible
keyboard.
See,
now I have the
keyboard.
Surface Pro here, which I love because I just fly, it's just so flat and short, and I just off I go.
We're all about choice here at
Microsoft. Yeah, absolutely.
Whatever works for you.
Surface Book, Surface, Surface Pro 2, Surface Laptop. We got you. Surface Pro. We got you covered.
Yes, we do.
And now with a, now with headphones.
Yep. Well, you know,
for
at,
some
at
of
some
us,
point,
some point,
at some point, you'll whatever. Have those. The headphones will be available in both the U.S. and the U.K. in time for the holidays. But
all right.
But which holiday?
Which holiday? Is that the Canadian Thanksgiving holiday this weekend?
Is that this weekend?
Yes. Check your calendar.
I need to get a Canadian turkey.
Check your Maple Leaf calendar.
Yeah. My Canadian friends would be very disappointed that I didn't know that.
I'm disappointed.
They do have an early Thanksgiving.
They do. They like to get ahead of the U.S. on a lot of things.
Yeah. It's like today Canadian Black Friday?
It could be Independence Day for all I know. Yeah. I think it's Canadian New Year's.
No, Canadian Independence Day is in like July. It's in the summer.
It's before
Canada Day.
Right, Canada Day. That's right.
Yes.
All right. Now we've sorry about that. We've
now offended an entire country.
No, we're sorry.
We're sorry.
That's it works in Canada.
It's true.
So what else do we have, Jeffrey? We got some other news.
Yeah, there is some other news actually. So you had mentioned about the Xbox update that's coming for October.
Soon.
But there's actually a Windows 10 update that'll be of interest of gamers that is now
it's available.
Yes.
In fact, I've got it right here.
So the gaming update features, they're on majornelson.com, of
yes,
course. So they've updated the game bar, and this is something I've been using a lot. I've been playing Forza Horizon 4 on my Surface Book
Play
2.
Anywhere title.
I do love it. And when you hit the Nexus button on your controller, it brings up this this game bar, and that's where you can do a lot of the things that you can do on an Xbox. The sort of in the guide, like record that, or you can pop up to look at achievements. There's new audio controls now, and there's just some other improvements, and even you can control interruptions that come through. So if you use a same computer to like have your email up and other things like that, you can actually now toggle this like master suppression of updates or of sort of like news pop-ups that would happen for like driver installs and things like that while you're playing. And, you know, that's what you want. Anyway, so what you need to do is if you have a Windows 10 PC, you literally just hit the Windows key, you type in the word update, and check for updates will pop up. And then you just click that check for updates button, you'll get it. It'll roll out. It began rolling out this week. Your computer will know when it's ready.
Yeah, I installed it. And if you want to, you can start. You can force the update.
You can force it if you really want to.
Yeah, and there's some really good stuff in there. They updated Edge now has been updated. There's a new screen snipping function.
I use that all the time.
Have you used the new one?
I haven't used the new
one. It is really cool. It's called Snip and Sketch. And if you open up the snipping tool, you can mark things up. It's really quite nice.
Yeah, I use the Windows Ink workspace for that. But
I think this is kind of like that.
Yeah.
So.
Again, multiple ways to get done whatever you want to do, whatever you're most comfortable
with.
Be
productive.
You know what one of the good Windows tips is that I learned from you?
What?
Of course I learned it from you. Is at any point, if you want an emoticon, Windows key period.
That's a great one, isn't it?
Yeah, and I feel like most people don't know that. And then you can just sift through all of the Unicode, like they're all there. All the emojis are there,
including, and I guess sometime in the future, we can expect the bagel one.
The roller coaster of emotions that I went through when
with
I saw that they were adding a bagel emoticon, and then
it looked like a Lenders.
It's exactly. It looked like a supermarket bagel, like if
a
you're
Lenders,
put
a frozen
a bagel,
bagel.
The type of people who will be excited about a bagel emoticon are the exact people that would never eat a bagel that looks like that bagel emoji.
Can I tell them the story how we're going to try to fix it? So earlier this week, Jeff and I had the opportunity to go to the opening of Shake Shack here in Seattle, which is opening very soon
in
Seattle.
We're a real city now.
Yeah, we've got a Shake Shack. We've never had one. Of course, we always hit the ones we go to New York and whatnot. And our good friend Laura from this Lollipop from the show, she works in downtown Seattle now. She works over at Apple.
Yep.
I don't know if you've heard of them. They make phones and computers and
iPods.
Anyway, so she's doing some work over there, and she joined us, and so we're all downtown, and she shows up. We sit down to eat our Shake Shack. I'm like, look, Laura, I need you to file a bug on the internal Apple. And she's like, what is it? I said, well, let Jeff explain. So she kind of looked at you and she looked at me and she rolled her eyes. She's like, should I pin my career on this? And I said, absolutely not. So
look, a bagel should have seeds on it. It shouldn't be doughy. I'll link to it. You can judge for yourself. There's a nice
picture. You should link to the story.
Apples bagel emojis about to upset a lot of New Yorkers.
Anyway.
And spiritual New Yorkers.
That's enough about the bagel. I love a good bagel with a good salt bagel. You know I love that.
I know.
That's my go-to. Anyway, so yeah, we got to see Laura, and unfortunately she was busy, couldn't join us for the show. We'll have her back sometime in the future, but it was good to be at Shake Shack, see her. It was a beautiful, beautiful fall day here in Seattle.
We really lucked out.
No, we sure did. Fall's coming up here in the Northern Hemisphere, one of my favorite times of the year. It used to be with the beautiful, bright, crystal clear days in New England and the leaves. I mean, if you really want to experience a nice crystal blue fall day with leaves, head to Forza Horizon 4.
It's always fall. Actually,
No, it's not.
1 week a month, it's always fall.
So you could get changed through all the...
Actually, the seasons changed to... I think they changed to autumn today.
I think you're right.
Yeah.
I think you're right.
I was on late last night, and I felt like I saw some
leaves
blowing
around.
Did
you feel the chill?
There was. I had to roll the windows up.
You did. You had to turn your seat heater on and close the bathroom.
I put the Miata away. I put the Roadster away.
Woo!
Couple more things we're going to bang through real quick on the news side. No Man's Sky. Spent a lot of time with this summer.
Yep.
And as Sean Murray said, No Man's Sky Next was really just the beginning for them and that they're going to be doing a lot more. And lo and behold, today, a vehicle update.
Sean Murray.
Murray.
You said Mary.
Mary? Well, that's a Philly thing.
It's Murray, dear.
Mary.
If we're going to do that.
How do you say it?
like Murray's bagels. Accent.
Yeah. Murray, it sounds the same to me. Anyway, No Man's Sky vehicle update is now live on Xbox One. He penned a post on Xbox Wire that talks all about it. But like when you're on these planets and you want to go around and you're mining and you're harvesting and you're scanning different things, you really do need a vehicle. You need a set of wheels. Even when we went to the moon for like 10 minutes, we brought a dune buggy. Right?
How American is that? When you go to the moon, you're bringing your own
car.
You're
driving. You're hitting a golf ball. Yeah. What else is there to do?
What else?
Yeah, exactly. If they could have watched football up there, I'm sure.
They would have.
They would have done it. They would have done it. Anyway, so there's a pretty big content drop there with a focus on Exocraft, and I'll link out to that. It's pretty cool. Did you see the new Red Dead Redemption 2 official gameplay video?
Of course I did.
Part 2.
Of course I did. Part 2. Of
course. So that came out this week.
Yeah.
And this is a game where Rockstar has us right where they want us.
Yes.
Every little drip feed of information,
yeah,
we're just lapping it up.
And
I'm getting real, we're getting real hungry for the
main course. I have a
funny
story about Red Dead after it releases that I can't tell now.
You can't tell now?
Nope.
About this Red Dead?
Yes.
Oh?
Because I do have some information, but I can't really talk about it right now.
Oh.
Tease.
Consider my interest incredibly peaked. All right. Well, we're going to come back. Let's put a pin in that.
Yep.
Also out now, because we're right in the crazy season of all the games coming out. WWE 2K19 mm-hmm. is out with our good friend mm-hmm. and Forza fan, AJ Styles.
AJ, I spent some time with him down at Turn 10.
Yeah, AJ, really good guy. A lot of these WWE superstars are big Xbox fans and really nice people. Even though they, for their day job, they hit people with chairs outside of the ring. Unbelievably pleasant.
Always.
Yeah. Mega Man 11.
Oh, yeah, that's loading on my console today.
Really? Okay, so that is out. Mega Man's back, 2D platforming. We all know what that is. There's a double gear system. I'm sure it's hard.
Mm-hmm.
The Mega Man games are hard. I look back, how did I beat Mega Man 2? After school, I would come home,
yes,
and I would just blow through Mega Man 2 like a want-no thing.
Weren't you like out enjoying the beautiful stylings of Philadelphia and or Florida, you know?
At that point, I was in Philly, and no.
It was probably best for you to stay inside.
wasn't the safest place.
Sure.
No, I came home, and I spent I got out from time to time. But
sure.
I used to come home and immediately turn on my Nintendo as soon as I got home. And then my mom would
yell
at me.
Did you get changed into your play clothes? Was that a thing?
That was not a thing.
Yeah,
I remember
when we come home, my mom would always say, you have to put your play clothes on, so we'd have to go out and get like our bad dungarees on.
I did not have enough clothes for play clothes. I think we talked about this before. Like I would watch Mr. Rogers and think it was unbelievably luxurious that he had two pairs of shoes to wear.
Okay.
And I was wearing, we came home. And I would fire up Mega Man for the 90th time and blow through it. That or DuckTales. Oh, what a game.
Also a good game.
What a game that was. FIFA 19. Yes. FIFA 19 is out. You know, that came out, I guess, technically officially last week, but we didn't have a show.
You did a great stream the other day.
I did a pretty good stream.
With Sounders.
Graham was awesome. So basically we teamed up. So if you've ever seen the Sounders jersey, if you ever come to PAX.
Sounders is the team here.
The local soccer team. Yeah. And if you've ever seen, like, if you've been here at PAX, you'll usually see there's usually a game at home that weekend, and everyone's like, wow, look at all these people with Xbox shirts. It's because we sponsor the Sounders, and so there's their kit sponsor. Every soccer team has an increasingly NFL teams as well, or NBA teams as well, have an advertiser, and it says Xbox. It makes it the best jersey in world football. Mm-hmm. I don't think anyone could argue with me. Anyway, so we teamed up with Mixer and made a special Mixer version of that jersey that will be worn on Monday against the Houston Dynamo. And so we figured, well, you know, we could just tell you that, like I just did, yeah. Or we can do a whole big FIFA face-off tournament from their headquarters. And
which
so that's what we did. And so we got 8 of the players, including a number of folks from the U.S. men's national team, which is pretty cool. Christian
yeah.
Roldan and Jordan Morris and a couple of other internationals as well. And just some hardcore gamers, guys that I know play. And we pitted them against each other. Christian Roldan ended up winning. He ended up beating Lamar Nagel in the finals, but we ended up having a fun time streaming it, and we ended up giving out in the chat an autographed jersey
what?
From the Sounders team. The
well
whole
done.
Team signed it. So if you're interested in finding that Mixer jersey, you can look online. You can look on the Sounders FC site. They've got a little video.
Where do
there
I find the stream if people want to see you?
Mixer.com/Xbox. Look on the past videos.
Yeah, it should be right there. In fact, my Inside Xbox is up there. A lot of This Week on Xbox. I mean, it's there's quite a bit of stuff up there.
Yeah, that's that. And then last one, this was actually a game I saw you playing, and I was curious your thoughts.
Yes.
That came out last week was Life is Strange 2, Episode 1.
Oh, I finished it.
Really?
Yeah.
You've gotten very into that series. You came back to it, because I remember you had some...
Issues
with the first one.
This and I just started playing it, and It's another, I mean, the narrative in there is so incredibly strong. I really, really enjoyed it. I don't want to say anything because I just don't want to ruin it, but I really, really liked it.
That's a Don't Nod, right?
Correct.
The voice
acting, the character development, all of it is just, it's top drawer, Jeffrey, top drawer.
Top drawer, yes, sir, yes, top drawer,
Kensington. We got to get back to that.
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Strange Brigade.
We need to play a little more Strange Brigade.
Yeah, so.
Queensberry rules.
Queensberry rules. Oh, good. Very Petrolio. Good.
Yes. Very, very good, sir.
All right. What else?
You know, I think that's probably enough.
Yep.
Next week. Call of Duty. Black Ops 4.
Here already.
I personally.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to going back into black. Back
into
blackout
yeah.
mode.
Mm-hmm.
That was. Did you? We played a little bit of.
We played a little bit. I played a lot of it without you because you were. I think you're getting ready to leave.
Heading off to Goodwood. But yes, people really loved it. It took
yeah.
over all the streaming services. That's what everyone was playing. We saw some amazing GIFs and GIFs of it. And we'll be playing that. Well, 1 week from today.
Yeah, so as if we need. I mean, this is the time. It is a glut of gaming.
Yes, but then after that, we do have a couple of weeks breathing period
before Red Dead.
Before Red Dead, and then very quickly after that is Fallout.
Right.
And
we have so much to play. I mean, doesn't all need to be played now, but we've got a bunch of stuff that's going to keep us busy for the holiday season.
But you want to, right?
But you do, of course.
I want to take a month off. That's what I want to do.
Maybe
just play
I will.
Games.
Should we do that?
Can we do that?
No, we can't. No, we've got. You know, the other thing we announced was XO.
Oh yes, XO18.
XO18 down in where you and I
Mexico
and the team,
DF.
Lots of Phil, the whole gang's going down to Mexico.
I love Mexico City. I'm very excited to go. Have you ever been?
Yeah, I've been once.
Okay,
remember sickness.
That's right. So you'll take some. You have to chew in some leaves or something. I think that's how they do it in Bolivia. There's some sort of like
yeah.
leaf that helps with.
No,
the,
I'll be fine.
I'll look it up for you.
Look at. Thank you.
Homeopathic remedies. I got gotcha. You.
Yeah. So you're here. Take this in your luggage. Don't worry about it.
It's fine.
I know how that works.
Do you?
Yeah. Well, I'm just saying.
I saw that movie. You saw Broke Down Palace.
I did. So No. I saw Marrakesh Express.
Yeah.
So a little deeper cut there. But yeah, we got XO coming up. That'll be in mid November. We're going to do a live show from there. It's our next Inside Xbox.
Yeah,
from there.
I cannot wait. It's gonna be big.
Big, I tell you, Jeffrey. Big. What else?
It's good. What else? What else? Could
I think it's that time of the year
yeah.
where we have to apologize.
Oh.
On behalf of Jeffrey and I apologize on behalf of our drivatars.
Yes. I have to show you this. Someone tweeted at me this morning. So, you know what? I'm just going to show it to you.
Forza Horizon 4.
I literally couldn't believe it.
My drivatar is a little aggressive. I'll tell you, his reel's aggressive. Phil Spencer's. My gosh, yeah.
He has not shown up in
one
of
mine. He and I played a couple of live games together, and it was great. But his was pretty aggressive.
All right, I've got to show this to you, and it will hopefully. I'm just stalling right now.
That's
while
fine.
I'm trying to find it.
Dun, 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 dun. We'll put it in the show notes. In fact, most of what we discussed today will be in the show notes. Including the Greek Isle project and a few other things. So Jeff is turning his laptop around.
This is what my drivatar got up to with Graham's drivatar.
What? It's on top of someone else's vehicle.
Yeah, it's on top of Graham's vehicle.
Oh, that's just...
Somehow I managed to pop my, I guess it looks like a Range Rover?
Yeah, it's a stack of Range Rovers, Land Rovers on there.
I must have done a jump.
Nice work.
And landed on to AC Bongos.
That's as well it should be.
Yeah.
We'll put a link to that in the show notes.
Yeah.
All right. We're going to wrap things up here. Thank you for hanging out with us today. Jeff, thanks for coming to the studio. I know we've
always happy to be
we've been real, it's been struggle getting into the studio to do a show. So here we are.
We're here.
We're working
by
on
popular
a
demand.
We're working on another show on Mixer, live video show. So I think our next podcast may be on Mixer.
People really like those.
They do.
They have a lot of energy. I just shook.
I actually have three. Espressos before I do those, not just two.
Yeah.
So
I could use some of that.
I need to look good too. So
share the espresso.
All right, so check out Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Check out Forza Horizon 4. Forza Horizon 4, part of Game Pass.
You probably already have it.
Did you know that? You should already
you should
have
known
it,
that. And check out Valkyria Chronicles 4.
Yeah.
I'm going to give you the hard sell on that.
If you want to catch up with Jeff, you have any complaints about the show, you can find him on social media on...
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Is that also your Insta?
Yes,
your Insta,
is.
As they
do you
say.
Like... You love making fun of me.
I do.
But then you do it.
I troll you on Insta all the time.
You do. And you make fun of me for taking pictures of the food.
Yeah,
or whatever.
You won't find food on mine, usually.
Well, people want to know what you're eating.
They
Larry.
Don't. Nobody knows
they
what
do.
I, they don't care.
This way people can analyze it. They can say, look, you're not
they can judge
enough
me.
Lycopene.
Yeah, that's
you
fine.
Know,
they can judge me.
We could crowdsource your nutrition.
Great. Thank you, doctors. Thank you. You can follow me at Major Nelson on Twitter and also on Instagram.
They know that.
So I know, but just in case they don't know. Anyway, you can also follow us on Xbox. I'm almost you there. You can find Jeff on Xbox as his gamertag is.
Rube.
Very simple.
Play with me.
It's in the show notes right above the very top of the podcast.
It is. Add my drivatar.
All right, gang. We will talk to you in a couple weeks. We do a video on Mixer, so keep an eye on my Twitter account. I'll let you know there. And we'll talk to you next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye.